what you're going through and don't understand it and know why you're going through it, you got to hold on. for about 10 years.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus.
And we don't do nothing else. I thought I was giving somebody to play a bugle or something. Have a jazz club. Hallelujah. God, you come here praise and worship God, man. We're going to get up out of here. We're going to pray and worship God. Take up on me, go. Because we be full.
Yeah.
That's where we at.
Yeah.
We don't need all that preaching and all that. We get that revelation. God give us that revelation too, because he always do through the exhortation. And that's true. He always gives us. We get up in here, man. We're going to praise and worship God. My God, who's going to go to moving? We get full of him. I slap his hand out of you. Man, you be good to go.
Glory.
I would have him talk to reality. He would think I'm sick. He would let me write him, he got cancer or something. I see they getting out early. I was looking at him, I was looking for 3 hours. He came out of here for about 30 minutes over there. What's wrong with y'all about? He got AIDS? This is a problem people come up with. Ain't God good. They won't even look at the message, they be looking at the time. 10 minutes. Don't go ahead. He got that thing going. That's what we're going to be there. And everything we need to be tapped on, God tapped with. Get some revelation. Then go ahead, straighten this up. Straighten that up. He said, straighten that up right there.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's what he do. You know, because we're ready.
Hallelujah.
We just got to get that praising right. Yeah. We have a revival break out there. Yeah. With your prayer.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we had a bunch of believers in here. Yeah. We're still working on believers, having believers in the church.
Thank you.
You would come in here feeling bad, even ain't feeling so good, you don't know what to do. That was anointing.
Amen.
So much power in that stuff. You struggle with being real 2 years, 3 years, you ain't got any healed. And I ain't telling you about them, I'm talking about you. Them and them, don't wait on them.
You can
make God pray, get God glory, till you get home, so you can't talk. Then you look at them talking about you wasn't in the same service I was, but you still didn't talk.
Yeah.
Well, we no talking out of church.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you be talking to me, that means you ain't giving all you got.
Come on.
Spend more time in the parking lot you do inside church.
Come
on. Yeah, like you sleep inside church. Man, God been doing something in your life, man, okay? Yeah. It's your shit. I've been taking it. It's your shit. You put something in that door, that thing stop you. Stop what you're from doing. You want to stop praying, praising God so bad?
Thank you, Jesus.
Because he knows the Lord was here. I'm going to be good. He's going to take praise. He's going to take praise. Gonna take praise from the people,
yeah.
From believers.
Yeah.
But he got to invite you.
Y'all, my soul,
thank you.
Your struggle is over. You just don't know.
Thank you.
Your sickness is over. You just don't know. Truth set you free.
Amen.
The truth set you free?
Amen.
My God, I God shine. And you think I'm going to go over there and deal with that thing with God? I'm going to go over here every day and lovely? Lovely. He never faded. He ain't do it like you want him, but he ain't faded. Thank God, good. He's something else, ain't he? You don't do it like you want to. He said, God, look at get in his way. He said, okay, I'm going to take you around the corner, around the block. Because you put my name on it, now you got to go through with it to see what it was me. See, you still keep your praise. That's all they said. Some of y'all fell in the tent right now. Look what God has blessed us with. Why are you praising that? Because you're going through with it right now. That's the trial of your faith.
Amen.
Thank God, good.
Hallelujah.
You got to stop letting that down. That's the trial of your faith. I mean, God will bless you with it.
Hallelujah.
God bless you with it. But keep praising. Keep going high enough. Keep lifting him up. But that's just trying your faith.
Thank you, Jesus.
And God will do something big. Say bigger.
Yeah.
Say better.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you get over that and stop complaining about that, God will do something big. When that stop being your conversation and go ahead and give God praise, because you know God bless you with that.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, by shout out. You're gonna get something better. Because you're gonna glory to glory. Say better and better.
Yeah.
See, that one hindering you, that conversation you have really hindering you from getting that. Because you just thought about something that God will bless you with. We should be praising God for what He bless you with. Even though it looks like after opposition coming up against you, the devil coming up, it looks like it ain't working out, give God praise, give God glory. Watch it work that way.
Amen.
That's trying to get faith. If you start with God, you have to finish with God.
Amen.
You can't get in the middle, ain't got in the middle of the race and quit. The race is not over. It ain't finished. It ain't done. Oh, it's still going on. Oh, he's still working on it. He's still turning around. say, you know, I'm just talking about you. Go pick up this guy. Say, okay. Because I start talking about the Bible, and I start talking about the Bible, yes, and I start talking about the Bible, and then I start talking about the Bible, and he can't go back to that Bible. So I start, she got to go back to the Bible. So I start talking about that Bible, and I'll get you to stuff out here. And he said, go to the head. I said, I don't know about that. Your deserve. But he's waiting on you to praise. He's waiting on you to worship. He's waiting on you to glorify God. And when I was just talking, the Holy Ghost just started talking. You hear that talk? Because he sees you. And you sit in the mind of it, but she knew he talked to him. And see, I say praise and worship. See, that was up there. That'll make it quicker. Say hallelujah, God. But you make it see that God Almighty God. Woo! God doing some things. And you gotta let God do some things. Let me pray for you, man.
Thank you, Jesus.
If you pray for you, for that Mr. God, Mr. God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
And Mr. Gottlieb Father, so I call it Mr. because that thing is unclear. That's what he tells. That spirit of God. I said, the spirit, I'm going to lay hands on. And she been adding up, God, but it's going to be, at the start of the day, it's going to start fading away. Things will get better. Command that spirit of burning. About things.
Thank you.
But you worried about the maturing, the grandchildren, the son. You worried about things, and that word, that pressure come on you. And that enemy gets in there. I know you ate something, but this right here comes from worry and concern. So things to be concerned about. And you get more concerned about it. And they bother you, like really bother you, but you go on, keep going. And say, God, God, and God won't move on. But it still be heavy on you. And God said, this right here comes from worry. Just don't come anybody to eat something, but this right here comes from worry. And this right here, after the enemy come in, that's how he snuck in, and he do, he can justify by what you ate. So he can justify stuff, and we'll claim it because that's what he tells us.
Amen.
Amen. But this right here came in through worry, because you were dealing with some things, and you was trying to deal with some things, and call about some things, and things were really bothering you. And something with things bother you, ain't nothing you can do about it. Amen. Y'all know that if some things bother you, ain't nothing you can do about it. You just have to take it. Amen. And that's what that's what the enemy bring the pressure. He don't let up to you because you can't do it about it. He still mess with you about it. Amen.
Amen.
But today I'm gonna lay your hands on you right now. The fire pulls going to run out and lay. your share. And they give me praise and give me glory. And they get to call the sinner's name. And command that devil to loose. Command the sinner.
Yeah.
say, in the name of Jesus, a ministering angel from on high in the mighty name of Jesus. Say glory to God. Because God will begin to miss the direction showing. I hear a ministering angel. Ministering angel. Listen to the 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 ministering angel. Stop confusing them with you. Listen to the ministering angel. Stop confusing them with your conscience. Stop hesitating. Move. Do it. Listen. Key into it. But they begin to minister to you. But they want to minister to you. As they minister to you, you begin to mix them up with you, your conscience. With other voices. The Bible says, walk by faith and not by sight. You got to do it in faith. If you do it in faith, if it ain't right, God won't let it come to pass. But you got to stay in faith. Don't be afraid to make a mistake. Don't be afraid to make an error. God will correct it. Stay in faith. Stay in faith. Because if you get away from faith, you get into sin. You got to walk by faith. So when you hear that message, angel, shout out about you. You can tell if it's an evil or it's good. Now, if you hear the angel jump off the bridge, that ain't no. Come on, somebody. Come on now. Use some spiritual senses. Say glory to God. Ain't no angel, ain't no devil going to tell you when you do that. The devil will tell you to do something because he wants to think you got the faith step out of faith to do it. God honor it because it's done in faith. If it's wrong, he'll correct it. Say hallelujah to Jesus. And after you suffer a while, you'll learn to say, man, I knew big time. That's the Holy Ghost. Say hallelujah, but you got to continue in faith. Stop letting your mistakes make you stop from walking in faith. Because minister angels are being released.
Hallelujah.
And they're going to begin to minister. Yeah. Yeah. And you can't let your doubt get in the way.
Thank you.
Walk in faith.
Yes.
And God will honor your faith.
Yes.
God said, I honor your faith.
Yes.
I honor your faith. I will honor your faith. God always honor your faith.
Yes.
And you got to obey him. When you hear the minister angels, whenever you tell you to do something, go somewhere, sit there. Go somewhere and do it. Praise God, no one died of the Holy Spirit. Spiritual, not because of the Holy Spirit. But the minister angel said, go to the hospital. Y'all ain't there? He said, go to the hospital. So I went to the hospital. And I sat him down. He said, go to the hospital. He said, go to the rooms. Y'all ain't there? So I went to the hospital. I sat him down. After a while, the Holy Ghost said, okay, now you believe. I just need you to be obedient to my voice.
Yes.
It ain't what you're going to do, just what I tell you to do, not what I can tell you. And a lot of times, you're going to take it upon yourself. But God said, go to the house. God will tell you to pray for me. Until you go to the house. You get in there, y'all be fighting in there. God said, call him. He didn't tell you to bring up nothing. He said, call him.
Yeah.
You should have been listening. You should have said, hello, hello. Okay. Bye. Love you. Why you calling me? He said, because the Holy Ghost told me to call me. He didn't tell me to say nothing. Just do what he said. By faith. I'm telling you, he's going to speak to you. See? God want to be able to trust you with his word. So he had you do things to show you, so you can entrust you, so your faith can be.
Yes.
And when you're scared of making mistakes and making errors, then that means you don't trust yourself.